woke up, it was a Chelsea morning, and the first thing that I heard was a song outside my window, and the traffic wrote the words. It came a ringing of like Christmas bells, and wrapping up like pipes and drums. Oh, won't you stay? We'll put on the day, and we'll wear it till the night comes. It was a Chelsea morning, and the first thing that I saw was the sun through yellow curtains and a rainbow on the wall.
The red, green and gold to welcome you, crimson crystal beads to beckon.
Oh, won't you stay? We'll put on a day as the sun shone every second. On a portrait of today, and the streets are paved with passers-by, and pigeons fly, and papers lie, waiting to blow away. Woke up, it was a Chelsea morning, and the first thing that I knew,
hi folks, this is Fuzzy Highgloss welcoming you to another episode of Inside the Mush Room. I'm kind of back to normal, whatever that is, after a really fun live show where I became a mushroom for a little while due to eating a weird mushroom omelet. But now I feel fine, and you know, except that I went and bought this groovy beatnik beret and these glasses because, I don't know, I just felt like, you know, doing a little bit of change, you know. We got a great show for you this week. Amanita and I won't be here that long because we got to go to Chicago to visit my dad, Buzz, on some personal business. But we'll have a great show because Rosalina Rossellini and Cookie Butterfly will be here. So they're going to stay here while we're gone. So, and this week, our album of the week is Joni Mitchell's Clouds. This week's theme for the show is art, and we decided to pick this record because Joni Mitchell did the cover art for it, and she's a, you know, in addition to being a musician, she's also an artist. Joni Mitchell did a lot of the covers for her albums, and she actually wrote this song, Chelsea Morning, which a lot of people mistakenly think it's, you know, Judy Collins, because, you know, because of the Clintons and stuff, and that she got a hit. But Joni Mitchell wrote the song, Chelsea Morning. And this week's book of the week is this great book, Classic Albums of the 60s. This has reproductions of some of the great album art from the 60s and from the 50s, some great jazz covers. And it's really, really great, beautiful colors. And sometimes you find albums that you have yourself and you realize that, you know, everybody owns this great art. It's not like in a museum or something. It's just like everywhere. So that's about, you know, we got to go now. Amanita and I got to catch the plane for Chicago. So we're gonna leave soon. And while we're gone, Cookie and Rosalina will be staying here, and they'll be taking over the show. Now, I'm not sure exactly what they're going to do. I think Cookie's going to make some lentil soup, I know that. And they're going to do something having to do with art, since that's the theme of the show. So we'll see you later from Inside the Mush Room. So are you ready for a romantic evening, weekend, here in the mushroom, all by yourselves?
Oh yeah, baby. It's gonna be great. We have all these groovy records to listen to.
Yes, I found this on the turntable. Joni Mitchell, Clouds.
Yeah, I dig Joni Mitchell.
I'm not familiar with this record, but look, she did the collage inside. She did it.
Groovy.
Also, she did the cover, too. She's an artist, no?
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Yeah, it's great.
Also, there is here the note from Fuzzy and Amanita about what we should do for the TV show, and where they a number for where they are, and feeding Bean. Perhaps we should feed Bean because he has been alone all this time.
Yeah, we should do that.
Bean? Beanetto?
Bean!
Bean! Dove stai, Bean?
Kitty!
Bean! Hello, Bean. I'm Rosalina. I'm going to feed you now. Ready? Mangia. Buonasera, I am Rosalina Rossellini, and I will be one of your hosts for Inside the Mush Room this evening, along with my partner, Cookie Butterfly. And we are big fans of the show Inside the Mush Room, so we know the format. We will try to stick to it this evening. However, we may vary slightly because we are artists and we must do our own thing, as you know. First, I would like to lead you through a gallery tour of the Mushroom Museum of Miniature Modern Art. Our first painting is by Matisse. It's called La Femme au Chapeau, and it is from his Fauve period.
Hey, Rosalina, look at this book that I found in the bookshelves.
Oh, I know this book. Yes, this is a fascinating book about a painter, Elmire de Hori, who did fake paintings. They were forgeries of very famous people like Matisse, Modigliani, Kees van Dongen. It's a fascinating book. It's written by Clifford Irving, and it's amazing because this painter, he sold these pictures to many collectors in the United States, all over the place. Even perhaps some museums may have these paintings right now at this time. It's quite a fascinating book. He was the most famous art forger of his time. I can't wait to read this while we are here in the Mushroom. But let's get back to the miniature museum. This is another painting by Matisse.
Are you sure that's by Matisse, Rosalina?
Because it is in the museum, I would think, yeah, it is by Matisse. Now let's go down. This is by Andy Warhol. It is called, what is this called?
National Velvet.
Oh, National Velvet is Liz Taylor, no?
Yes.
And then now we move down to the Willem de Kooning.
Oh, the late work.
It's got a little late. And move up, we see the Stuart Davis. And then just above that is a very tiny, tiny little painting.
Oh, that's miniature.
Now that's a miniature painting by, I believe, Diebenkorn. And here we have a lovely painting by Frida Kahlo, Frida and Diego. Beautiful, no? But the thing about these paintings is that they're not very miniature. They're almost full size. This one and this one. So perhaps we can alter them because I always love to alter the found pictures. So I'm going to cut out my favorite part of this picture, so that we remove the part that we really like, and then it will be miniature. Because right now it's not very miniature, it's almost full size. So, and then we'll put it back up in the museum, and we'll have a truly miniature museum.
When I first saw you gallery, I liked the ones of ladies, but now the faces fall.
And now in keeping with the theme of miniature art, I'm going to show you a painting I'm going to do where we alter this pre-existing little Elvis thing. I'm going to make Elvis more glamorous. We will start with a little bit of red for his lips. Now we will put a little bit of red here just to highlight his lips. And now a little bit of blue. He needs a little bit of, you know, for around the eyes, just a little coloration. Now he needs a little bit more eyelashes because his are too short. Although they are beautiful, but we need to give him some more. He looks better already, no? Now a little rouge for his cheeks. Now he needs a little more hair. A nice do for him. Hair. You're changing Elvis. He needs a makeover, no? I believe the transformation of Elvis is completed. It's a cute little painting, Elvis. I call it Elvis GI Blues.
Hey man, Cookie Butterfly here with the book of the week. We're gonna go right to my favorite section, the psychedelic section. Like, this is the 13th floor elevators from 66. This is a way groovy album by The Fool from 69. The Floyd from 68. Love, 67. Dig this trippy cover from Hap Hash and the Colored Coat. The Supernatural Fairy Tales record from 67. Dig the trippy collage on this cover from the Chocolate Watch Band from 68, man. Inner Mystique. This is the Incredible String Bands, the 500 Spirits album from 1967. Wow. Electric Music for the Mind and Body by Country Joe and the Fish from 1967. Gandalf, 1969. This album from the Insect Trust from 1968 looks like it's got a psychedelic Rorschach on it. Tiny Tim entered the psychedelic era in 1968 with God Bless Tiny Tim. This is from the Sacred Mush Room with an eponymous album from 1969. Here's an album from Harvey Mandel. Wow, even Paul Revere and the Raiders had a psychedelic cover on this album. This is Red Crayola's Parable of the Arable Land album from 67. This album from The Power Plant from 1967 cost $4.79. The Power Plant. Look, it's got renderings of my favorite plant on it. Well, that's all the time we have for the book of the week. Hi, brothers and sisters. This is Cookie Butterfly. Now I'm gonna show you how to make some delicious, healthy lentil soup. Here's what you'll need. And ice cream's everywhere. Here's some lentils that I've soaked overnight. It's important to soak them overnight. I have a mixture of red and green lentils here. Some celery, two or three stalks. A big bunch of cilantro. Doesn't that smell good?
Mmm, bella.
Carrots. Today we're putting some red chard in the lentil soup because this chard was marked down, reduced for quick sale, so I bought it. It'll be good in the soup. A yellow onion and some garlic. Now for the spices. We're going to use a mixture of spices. It's going to be like a curry. For seeds, we have mustard seeds, coriander seeds, cumin seeds. I've got two little cloves there. You don't want to use more than two cloves because cloves are very strong. The most important ingredient is the ground cumin. You want to use a lot of that. And over here we have ground cardamom, cayenne pepper, cinnamon, turmeric, and mustard seed. Hey, I have a friend in Chicago named Mustard Seed. All of these ingredients that I'm using in the lentil soup today were organically grown, man. And I'm going to be using natural spring water to make the soup. Alright, man, I've brought the lentils to a boil and now I'm letting them simmer. Oh, and I forgot to tell you, put a bay leaf in there with it. Yeah, I've told myself 1,000 times I should not get stoned before I do this. Anyway, it's time to put the spices in. First, crush your seeds and your cloves in your mortar and pestle. Now add the rest of the spices, man. Let the lentils simmer for about 20 minutes, and that'll give you time to chop up your vegetables.
Smells great already. The cilantro smells exquisite.
The lentils have simmered for about 25 minutes, so it's time to put in the carrots and onions. Let that simmer for about 10 more minutes, and then we'll put in the celery. The lentil soup has simmered for a total of 30 minutes, so now I'm going to add the celery and the stalks from the chard. Let the soup simmer for 10 more minutes, man. The lentils are cooked. Now I'm going to add the garlic at the last minute so it doesn't cook very much. Salt and pepper to taste. This is natural sea salt. Now I'm going to add the juice of one lime, man. I forgot to tell you about this in the beginning, because like I said, I should not get stoned. But squeeze in fresh lime juice. Now I'm going to just let it sit there and all mix together. Turn the fire off and the flavors will do their thing for about 5 minutes. Now I'm ready to serve the lentil soup. I don't want to cook the greens because cooking destroys essential nutrients and enzymes, man. So I'm going to put some of the cilantro and the chard in the serving bowl and pour the soup on top of it. This looks delicious. Soup's ready, Rosalina.
Bellissimo.
Grazie, Bella. Would you like some nutritional yeast in your soup, Rosalina?
Si.
It's loaded with B vitamins.
It's like cheese, like formaggio.
Si, Bella. It's so wonderful being here with you, Rosalina.
Yes, it is so romantic.
I really dig you, baby. You know, it's too bad we don't have any wine. Fuzzy and Amanita don't have any wine in here.
Is there I'll take my thirsty fill of friendship over wine?
Well, you know I can't drink because I'm a recovering alcoholic anyway, so we'll have water. It will be like wine. Thank you so much, Cookie, for making this beautiful lentil soup. Exquisite.
Prego, Bella.
I would love to give you something in return. I'll give you a song.
I remember your eyes were bluer than robin's egg.
Thank you.